Hey, it's Vaughn, and welcome back to Let's Play The Elder Scrolls V Skyrim, ladies and gentlemen. In the last episode, we collected all three fragments of the Goldur amulet, and now we need to reforge it. We also solo killed our first dragon, and the remains should be over there in the distance. I don't think you guys can see it, but you guys should have seen it. If not, I don't know why you're really watching this episode if you haven't seen the other one all the way through. But anyways, we need to go over here to some random cave, it looks like, and get our reward for this pretty lengthy side quest. Now, we have one amulet fragment that increases our health by 30? I think it's 30. 30 points? I guess I should make sure. Let's see what we got. Yeah, so we have one that increases our magicka by 30 points, one that increases our stamina by 30 points, and one that increases our health by 30 points. I wonder what happens when we reforge it. I wonder what reward we're going to get. Why did it say that I can enter? Look at this. This is so weird. The entrance is actually over there, but it's doing that little entrance thing right here. All right. Reach Water Rock. What do you have in store for me? Level 8. Arcane Master Adrenok. Hello? I'm here to reforge the Goldur amulet. Hello? Anybody? I don't think Adrenok would call out like that. No. In fact, he definitely would not. Come on, Vaughn, get into the role-playing spirit. Okay. Adventurer. Lost Legends. This was the book that we read to start us off on this quest. Potion of Minor Healing. And even though this guy probably died valiantly, I'm gonna go ahead and drag his body over the edge because I need to. Oh, wait. There's quite a large amount of water, which means probably some hidden chests down here. There's one right there with an adept lock. One of the things people always give me shit for is my lockpicking skills. I mean, I've really taken time to think. Oh god, I just realized I said that I was going to realize what I was going to do with those perk points in between the last episode and this one, and I haven't done that. Damn it, I always do that. I say I'm going to do something, but I completely forget about it. It's not that I don't want to do it, or it's not that I don't do it. It's just that I forget about it. But like I said, it doesn't really matter that much because we still don't have any. I think we just breathed air there. Yeah, we definitely did. We just breathed some air underwater. Okay, I think that's the only chest action. And we just did it again. Yeah, it's like whenever we're colliding with this terrain, it's like having, it's, yeah, see, it keeps doing it. Okay, let's get out of here. I think that's gonna be it. Oh wait, there's a skeleton as well. But yeah, what I was saying was, just like the last time I mentioned this, we don't really have any other spells. Let's take a look at what we have. So for alteration, we have Candlelight and Oak Flesh, both useless because Candlelight, we don't need to see any better. At least I don't. I know it's probably coming out darker in the YouTube videos. And Oak Flesh, we haven't had any difficulties other than dragons, really, with taking damage. Illusion, Clairvoyance, we know where we're going. Fury, it's pretty cool, but still kind of useless. I'm gonna need more stuff. I don't just wanna cast Fury, because then I'm just gonna switch back to Firebolt. There's not anything else I can do. Destruction, of course, we have Firebolt. Bound Sword and Raised Zombie, both cool, but yeah, so that we just don't have, once we get a bigger library of spells, don't worry. I will be putting those points into cooler stuff. I promise, you just have to have patience, that's it. Okay, here we have the Emerald Dragon Claw as well as an Ancient Edict. Let this place be forgotten forever. Let it be struck from the rolls of history. Let it never be spoken by any man or myrrh. Let its very name be lost to the ages. By the way, myrrh is referencing any of the elves. Dunmer, Falmer, Bosmer, Altmer, etc. Ye who enter here, know, this place was sealed at great price. Honor those who perished here, turn back, and leave them to their rest. But that, of course, is something Adrenok would simply not do. By the way, I love how the claw is, like, right there. You don't even have to do anything to get it. So anyone could literally come here and open this door, but it remains unopened. I guess we just do not have the brain of a three-year-old. Okay, Emerald Dragon Claw, and we're going to have Bear, Whale, and Snake. Bear, this should be Whale, and this should be Snake. By the way, one thing I noticed with these puzzle doors is that they never already have one correct ring in place, which really strikes me as odd, because if I was a game developer, I'd be like, all right, so the others didn't really have one correct one, let's make this one have one correct one. But that's never the case. I don't even know if there's one like that in the entirety of Skyrim. By the way, though, this is one of the coolest gameplay mechanics I've ever seen. Like, I really like the different gemmed claws and this specific door and the puzzle, even though the puzzle is extremely easy to solve, and people have said that's because it's supposed to keep the Draugr inside, not people outside. Whoa, we've got multiple doors here. I forgot about this one is more ornate. Uh-oh, is it the same one here? No, it's definitely not. Wait a second. Oh, what claw is that? We need to use all the claws. Makes sense. Okay, so that one is the ivory. How are we supposed to know it's the ivory? I guess it's the only other one that we got, right? So hawk, dragon. Oh, I was, look at that. As soon as I said that, I was wrong. This one's already in the correct place. This one doesn't count, okay? Because we already did something with the ivory claw. Hawk, dragon. Yeah, and my perfectionist OCD qualities are, like, going off the charts right now because it's like, why didn't you give me three claws? There's three brothers. There should be three claws and three doors, but there's only two, and that's like, ugh, why? Makes me sad. Moving on, though. See how ornate this quest is? I already used the word ornate. You see how just fleshed out and cool this quest is? It's really nice. Okay. Oh boy, what do we have here? Another big open chamber with tons of sarcophagi lying about. I wonder what could happen. Hi, hello? Activate amulet pedestal. This is very Indiana Jonesy as well. Hey guys, remember me? I killed you all. Remember that? You gonna do it again? I'll do the same thing. I'll kill you all again. As long as I get a reward and as many times as it takes. Okay, so these guys do have different, you know, little gameplay mechanics. Let's take out the smaller Draugr first. I'm not sure if they just keep spawning. But if they do, I just realized. No, they can't. Okay. This would be an excellent time to use. Oh, Highborn is gone. Why is it gone? It should still be there, even if we can't use it, right? Oh, I guess not. Okay, well, that's a good way to know. But that also really sucks, because this would be the best use of Highborn so far. But we do have a bunch of magic potions, although, as you can see, it takes a lot. So what I was saying was, if these Draugr do nonstop respawn, that means that we can just increase our destruction over and over and over and over. Okay, but now we need to use some healing. Pretty sure if you're a mage, the restoration is increased. I'm not sure if I've mentioned this yet or not, but it feels like when I use healing on... Wait a second. We're using the inferior healing spell, aren't we? Heals the caster 10 points, heals the target. Oh, never mind. We can only use that on targets. Okay. I think a good game design would be having a way to restore your magicka, not just waiting around. Because your magicka restores much faster if you're not in combat, right? But how does that make sense? What if we're just standing here waiting? Unless you say, like, well, you're scared or your adrenaline is coursing through your veins, so you can't concentrate on your magicka restoring or something like that. But there needs to be a gameplay mechanic. I'm not sure what. Maybe if you find, like, a soul gem, you're able to, like, pull some magicka out of it. I'm not really sure, because those just have souls, so I'm not sure if that makes sense or not. But, like, we're just waiting here, and I don't think this is good gameplay design. We're waiting for our magicka to restore. Of course, we could have prepared. Why is this guy taking no damage? We could have prepared with potions, but still. Why are you taking no damage, McRule? I'm trying to remember which person you were. Yeah, it looks like we need to hit him once and then hit him again. So I guess what we can do is equip Unrelenting Force, use the rest of our magicka potions. And also Potion of Destruction would probably be good. Destruction spells are 20% stronger for 60 seconds. Let's use that as well. And then we'll get rid of his little barrier with that, although it looks like it didn't. Okay, so yeah, McCruel isn't really good for mages because you have to hit him constantly or else he gets that shield back, it looks like. Or maybe it's just gone for good? No. So maybe, do we have a weapon? Guldur Blackblade. We could use his own... Or actually, we have the Staff of Yurik Gulderson. Yeah, let's use that. Yeah, there we go. I'm using the Staff of your father against you. Boom! Wait, is it the father? No, it's one of the sons, I think. Okay, so one has been defeated, and we've got two more to go. Yeah, maybe you're supposed to use this staff for this fight. Oh, we have this thing again. Oh my god, that's a lot of Sigdis Guldersons. Okay. Can we tell this time as well? It doesn't look like it. Yeah, they all have the same helmet this time. No, they have different helmets. Okay, it's this one over here, though. We'll look for the one with the... see, it's not that... Oh, it was that one. I'm not really sure what's going on, if you can't tell. I guess we'll just get rid of them. Like so. Okay, and hold still. Hold still. Damn it. The stat's pretty cool, but we're running out of juice. Yes, stand still. Okay, and the staff is done. Let's switch back to our firebolts. I think it's better to just use one firebolt for the clone until we find the real one. Yeah, that's smarter. Boom, there you are. Yeah, this one's the most annoying one. Okay, where are you, you goddamn trickster? And that must mean... Does it mean? Or are you over there? Okay, I guess you're that one. Did we kill you? Appear back up there, please, and seem defeated. Thank you. Alright, final one. Wait, what? Sigdis again, didn't we just kill him? Why is he like that? What is going on right now? Are we fighting all of them? No. Yeah, the other one's gone. Are we fighting like two at once? I'm not really sure what's happening right now. And this really sucks because we're pretty low on magic. Magicka. Okay, let's use another staff. Let's see. Summons a familiar for 60 seconds wherever the caster is pointing. Can we dual wield staffs? Oh, we can. Wow, reanimate a weak dead body. That's not going to matter. Mage light isn't going to matter. Okay, dual wield staffs time. I've never done this before. All right, so familiar. What is it going to be? It's going to be a wolf, right? Yeah, okay. And this is Yurik. And he's resisting the frostbite. Alright, so you get shouted. Can we just keep summoning these? Or I'm pretty sure we only summon one at a time, right? Yeah, that sucks. Alright, well, I guess we just need to wait for our magic to regenerate. And in the meantime, we'll keep summoning these familiars. Which are doing a little bit. We'll take another. Looks like we can only summon one more. Come on, wolf. Or familiar, do your thing. Okay. Now let's, I was gonna say shout him, but can't. Resisted firebolt. Is this guy just 100% resistant to magic? Okay, so this is the guy that we fought with Tolfdir. So, yeah, he's like invincible. But how do we get rid of that invincibleness? Invincibility? There is like a little guy over here that's like on the floor? I'm forgetting this part. Okay, so if we hit him, he just shrugs it off. But there's also a guy over here, but that's Sigdis, isn't it? Yeah, that's Sigdis. So what the hell are we supposed to do? There are some dead bodies on the ground. There's no way I'm gonna actually have to look this up. Okay. Bear with me, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get the Staff of Zombies out. And is there anything else that we have? Maybe we just have to use the black bow. That's probably what's gonna have to happen. But let's reanimate a zombie real quick. Okay, now let's use the Guldur Black Blade. See if that does damage. It does do damage. Alright, so I guess he's just resistant to magic. Because we tried frost, it didn't work. We tried fire, it didn't work. Okay, and it looks like he disappears as well. Come on, zombie. What are you doing? All right, so now he's glowing again, which means we'll probably have to maybe use some magic against him. Yeah, I'm not really sure what the mechanic is with this guy. I'm trying to figure it out, but I am just not getting it. It's really weird. Because we did kill him with magic the first time when we fought him with Tolfier, but now it looks like he's resistant to all magic, so I'm not really sure. Oh, wait, now he's not? Yeah, now he's not resistant to magic. I'm gonna have to look this up after I finish this episode and realize where the hell I went wrong. But nevertheless, that's all three of them defeated, I believe. Uh-oh. What is going on with Zygdus? Okay, that was a glitch or something. Because now they're all gone. Hello? Okay, I wasn't sure if we... that was a lot of rambling and stupid things that I was saying. I'm fully aware of that, but that just threw me for a loop. It's not often that you get confused in Skyrim, because normally it's just, hey, look, there's a waypoint. I need to go over here and do this. All right, it's that easy. But, yeah, I do remember always getting confused with this last fight. Like, the other guys are easy, but that one guy, it's like, what is going on there? I don't really know. Maybe he just has different resistances at different points in the fight. You need to kill him with, like, magic, and then weapons. I'm not really sure. But anyways, nevertheless, here is the Galdur amulet, and is worth a whopping 1,864 gold. And is that going to complete the quest? Indeed it is, and here we have Galdur, who's just going to have... Oh, wow, that's actually a lot of gold. 403 gold. I just saw gold, so I was like, all right, so it's just going to be a small amount of gold. No, a whopping 403, so make sure to search Galdur for that gold. All right, I think we're already at full health. We are, but I just wanted to make sure. And let's take a look at our reward, shall we? Here we have... The Galdur amulet increases your health, magicka, and stamina by 30 points. I think this is the best amulet in the entire game, because think about it. That's pretty much 9 levels right there, right? 30 points each, 10 points a level, so 90 points. Or 9 levels, sorry. Let's equip that, and now we are significantly more powerful, I think. Alright, so that quest is over with, and also... This wall has been revealed. We have a pretty big coin purse there. And in the chest, Flawless Garnet, 133 gold. Lesser Soul Gem, we will take that. Clairvoyance, which we've already read. Amulet of Mar, restoration spells cost 10% less to cast. Amulet of Akatosh, magicka regenerates 25% faster. Pretty good. Still not better than the Galdur amulet, however. And Hide Boots of Major Stamina. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, we have completed the Forbidden Legend quest and all of the locations revolving around it. And this is why Skyrim is just so incredibly good, because this is what you want out of a fantasy game. A lot of people say Skyrim has, you know, it's dialed back in terms of role-playing, and it's a little streamlined and modernized and easy, if we're all being honest. But at the same time, this is what you want in a fantasy game. You want to delve into a dungeon, you want to do a quest that's actually fun and not repetitive, and then be rewarded with a really good item, as well as a unique experience all the way through. And that's exactly what that quest is. And it's amazing. It's really well done. And I applaud Bethesda for it. Which means we are back onto the Mage's Guild. I've been asked to find more information on the subject object found in Sarthal. Urag suggested that useful books may have been stolen from the Arcanium by Othorn, a former apprentice at the college. I thought it was Othorn. Othorn. His last known location was Felglow Keep. Find the stolen books, and Felglow Keep is going to be right over here. To the Ritual Stone we go. Oh look, we have the most horrifying enemy in the entire game, a Hagraven. Few creatures match the cunning of the Hagraven. That was the full quote. You guys can trust me. Okay. Is that going to be Felglow Keep in the distance there? Look at that draw distance. Wow. Now, if only it showed everything in high-resolution textures. It is popping up. That's unfortunate. Again, just because everybody gets confused about this and everybody seems to think that it's not the case. Not about the graphics, but about this second thing I'm going to say. Number one, we are playing on the absolute maximum settings for the vanilla game. You know, obviously this has no mods installed, like I said, but it does have the absolute highest settings for every aspect, and also the high resolution texture packs, because they're official, they're not mods, they were official releases. Oh, hi there, Thalmor Justicars. Wow, are we enemies of the Thalmor? I don't think we are. I'm surprised they're actually attacking me right off the bat. I'm also surprised they're falling pretty easily here. Damn it. Okay, let's just dodge his stuff. Come on, I'm gonna jump over this one. Ready? Oh, it hit me. Okay. Well, take that. Okay, we need to really watch out here because we could definitely die. Oh, this magic regeneration. All right, I'm gonna have to make sure to now he's using shocks to drain my magicka. I'm gonna have to make sure to. Oh, geez, we're actually in a really bad situation here. Okay. We need to use the rest of... Oh, we only have one more. God damn it. Okay, let's use one of these just in case. Conjuration. Okay, we just need to outrun this guy, I guess. Wow. There's actually an enemy that is giving us a lot of trouble. Okay, now we just need to wait here. Unless we can use Highborn. No, we're still not able to. Okay, we just need to wait here and let our magic regenerate because we have no other potions. We don't have Highborn accessed or accessible. Oh my god! Get away from me, dude! Get out of sneak! Ugh. Wow. I never would have thought that the most troublesome enemy in my entire Let's Play so far is going to be this Thalmor Justicar just because he's using shock magic. Maybe we could sneak out of this? I don't think so, but... Yeah, we'll just have to keep circling around him. And then before we go into Felglow Keep, we're definitely going to wait 24 hours so that we can get our Highborn back. Now, it could be safer and use the healing spell, but I think we'll just go ahead and... Oh, that one missed. Oh my god, come on now. What? Okay, we do have healing potions at least. Seem to be forgetting about that. Alright, one more should do it. No, he keeps healing himself. Thank God. Wow. Wow. Justicar execution order. Oh, I wanted to read that. Okay. We already have that enchantment. Thalmor stuff is cool looking, though. And we are a high elf. But we wouldn't get the 50% magic regeneration, so... Even though I really want to wear this stuff. Well, we could wear this, I guess. Yeah, and we'll look a little bit cooler. And magic regeneration is a big problem right now. Let's just make sure that we do have 50% magic regeneration. I know that we do. Yeah, magic regenerates 50% faster. Although we could just enchant this. Yeah. Oh, wait, no, it's already enchanted, so we can't. All right, we're just going to take it anyways. I'm not really sure how enchanting works 100%. So we'll take that, and we'll see if we can put... No, because I know we need the enchantment perk for being able to put two enchantments onto one item. So we're not going to be able to do that. Also, the thing that I wanted to do was because this guy gave me so much trouble, I need to desecrate his body. So bear with me for a second here. Let's just... Oh, you have a terrible hairstyle too. Wow, I was almost killed by this guy. All right, there's no water inside, unfortunately. So I'm going to have to give you a hearty toss down the mountainside. Okay, no. That wasn't the hearty toss. Hold on. Here's the hearty toss. And, alright, that's not going to work out. So, next best thing. Alright, it's going to have to do, goddammit. Let's go up this way. Oh my god, that was tough. And that took like a lot of this episode, wow. A lot of this episode. Alright, Felglow Keep has been discovered. And there's guaranteed mages out here. Oh look, a Flame Atronach, wonderful. Alright, but if we kill the Conjurer... That should take care of that. I think, anyways. It was already here. Someone didn't actually conjure it. Novice Ice Mage. Just what I want to see. Okay. Hello? Oh. Nope. Put that away, because we want to do this. Oh, yeah. I forgot. Mages start getting really difficult once they actually start using wards. None of them have really been using wards just yet. And that will just cut our magic damage down to nothing. And it also, like, blocks shouts as well. Okay, let's use fire against the Flame Atronach. Oh, wow, it doesn't do anything to it. Okay, well, that's unfortunate. I guess we do need to put a destruction spell as a backup. I guess flames or sparks would be the next best thing. All right. Yeah, it's about time for another magic upgrade, another spell upgrade. Okay, that's cool. Lock me into the execution animation so I can't get out of the fiery explosion of the frost or fire Atronach death. All right, let's eat these frost salts. Delicious. Weakness to frost. Wonderful. And before we head into Felglow Keep, the entrance is right over there. Let's number one, equip healing. And number two, search the outside for any chests. Not gonna be in here. There was one mage. Ah, this one. We did not loot this one. Daedra Heart. Delicious. Okay, what do you have on this table? Frost Miriam, some horse meat. And what is this? Felglow Keep requires key. Alright. Anything else out here? Does not look like it. How about in this water? Gotta be a secret chest, right? Secret chest, where are you? I know you're here somewhere. Gosh darn it! I keep saying the other word. I need to say gosh darn it instead for those of you that cringe every time Vaughna curses. I understand it. You're not used to it. I get it. Into the Felglow Keep dungeons. Oh boy. Alright, things are getting a little bit more difficult. They definitely are. Yeah, there's been a ramp in difficulty. Still manageable, of course. Let's take all of this scaly Foliota? Ray Liotta. Let's take all that scaly Ray Liotta. And let's see what we have. Like I said, I will sneak when it's applicable. We don't want to just run in going, hey, I'm a mage, here's some fire. No, we want to be at least a little bit stealthy, even though it's not our, Gosh darn it, Skyrim, why do you always minimize for no reason? Please do not close out. It's like, I know I've said this, and I've said this on stream a lot too, but it's only Skyrim that does this. I've never had an issue with any other Steam game, and my Steam library is pretty big. It's got a lot of games in there, and I've played a lot of games. Huh? What is and it? I've never had an issue like that. We can't shock water, right? This isn't Bioshock. I don't think so. No, definitely not. Oh man, we just activated a whole bunch of stuff. Was that smart? Probably not. But at least we can wait here. Ah! Don't you fire gross things at me. Dude! Come on. I've been doing so good with this firebolt accuracy. Okay, we've got a mage up here, it looks like. This is my least favorite type of dungeon, by the way. All those, everything went everywhere. By the way, not a good idea to do that in closed spaces like this, because you have a chance of knocking off books that are skill books and you don't realize that they are, and then you never find them. But there are multiple iterations of each book, so it's not like you'll never see the book again. Nothing? Nothing for me anywhere? Okay. Yeah, this is my least favorite type of dungeon, because even though, like I said, Skyrim does, like, handcraft each one. Oh, I wonder what this is gonna do. Oh, look, poison darts. These types of dungeons, this type of dungeon, I should say, all look the same. Like, they just all look like the same thing. Oh, look at that. No thanks. Hey, there's nothing happening over here. Nothing at all. Yeah, see, he warded there. Yeah, and he keeps warding. And when he's doing that, he takes no magic damage. So, once we get, you know, further into the game, they're going to start warding more often. And then we are going to be doing less. So don't worry, the difficulty will ramp up. What do we have in here? A whole bunch of cells with people inside. I think I know who they are. Can we talk to them? Hello?
Out of the way, meat.
Yeah, they're vampires, but it looks like they're not aggroing, so we will open these cages. Getting pretty low on lockpicks here, which I never like. Okay, are you gonna aggro? No? Oh, you're just gonna... Oh, that's right. I remember this. Okay, so we want to get them all out as soon as possible. Come on. There we go. And... Oh, yeah. There's actually levers here. But we actually... You know, we want to get the lockpicking experience. So we'll just open all of these. So, yeah. If you do that, they'll all run out and start fighting the mages, which is really good. A really good thing to happen. And then we can take our time and explore these cells. There's not going to be anything inside. Wow, there's an absolute massacre happening outside. I wonder who wins. Looks like it's going to be the mages, because there were a lot more red blips than vampires, it looked like. All right. Really don't like how low we're getting on lockpicks here. So I need to be more careful. Okay, looks like there's not going to be anything in any of these cells other than the vampires. Let's go ahead and help out a little bit if we can aim. I'm not sure if that one was friend or foe, but it's quite all right. The firmament, got some gold in there, coin purse. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to end this episode here. Goodbye, vampires, even though I'll kill you later on in Dawnguard, probably, or maybe not. I'm not sure what we're going to side with or who we're going to side with Adrenok. Probably the vampires, actually. Thanks for watching. We're going to end this one here. Like I said, I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.